hear what you're saying, but it doesn't make sense. There is no version of Danny being dead that makes sense.
Did Danny have any enemies? Anyone he had an issue with recently?
No. Everyone loved Danny.
Well, clearly not everyone.
Yeah.
It's okay. She's right. Someone killed Danny, and me sitting here sugarcoating things isn't gonna help you find who killed him.
Was your husband's history with drug abuse public knowledge?
Danny didn't use drugs.
I'm afraid he did.
He was a recovering addict, and whoever killed him knew that.
He was my husband. Don't you think I would notice something like that?
You wouldn't be the first wife who found out her husband was a guy with some secrets.
Could you excuse us, please?
About that, can you tell me where Danny was last night?
He was at a bachelor party at China's Den. He left a message saying he was coming home. And he never made it. Danny was a perfect guy I'd waited my whole life for. He was funny and loving and generous. And now he's gone. How is that fair?
It's not.
I know who I was married to. He was a good man. Whoever this Connor Thorne guy is, he's not Danny.
Okay, Danny, maybe you should sit down.
Don't. I'm not some child that needs to be handled, okay?
No one is trying to handle you. Look at me, Jenny. Woman to woman, widow to widow, I promise you, we're telling the truth.
You lost your husband too?
Yes. And the hardest part can be finding out they weren't perfect.
Danny clearly had his reasons for lying to you, but doesn't mean he didn't love you.
We need your help. Danny had a fight with this guy at the strip club hours before he died.
We think it may be someone from his past. You recognize him?
God, that's Troy. Troy Randolph. He lives across the street.
Damn.
Of course my DNA was all over Danny. He was my husband.
Roll up your sleeves. Bitch, don't make me climb over this table and do it for you. Let me tell you a story. You like stories? It's about a woman. Let's call her Penny. She moves to Miami, marries what she thought was the perfect husband. They live in their perfect little suburban house. Probably plan to get a dog, eventually throw in a kid or two. And then a nosy, lovesick neighbor comes over and tells her that her perfect life is all a lie. He even has proof that Penny's husband is a wanted criminal and tried to pay the neighbor off to keep him quiet. Realizing her whole marriage is a sham, Penny flips her lid and kills her husband. Don't you love that story?
You have no idea what you're talking about.
I get it. I get the impulse to kill him for lying. I really get it.
I know why she did it.
Yeah, thanks, but I think we got it figured out.
No,
you have it. Danny into the cops. Why kill him?
Because killing Connor Thorne was her plan all along. Danny's stepfather is Walter McCall. He committed suicide after Connor lost all his money.
You tracked Connor down to Miami to make him pay for what happened.
Connor got what he deserved. I lost the only father I had ever known because of him.
And I would feel sorry for you if it was just about avenging your father, but you showed your true colors. Somewhere along the way, it became more about greed for you.
That's why you didn't kill him when you first found him. You had to find the money first. Money you felt entitled to.